Hi everybody, my name is Pulkit Chhabra. In this series, we'll be discussing the next contest of the Core Forces, which is Educational Round 87. And in this video, we'll be discussing its first problem, which is A, alarm clock. So let's get to it. Okay, I'll just read the problem out. The problem says that Polycarp has spent the entire day preparing problems. Now he wants to sleep for at least a minute to feel refreshed. Okay, just pay some attention. I also had some trouble understanding the question in the first course, so you better pay attention. Polycarp can only wake up by hearing the sound of his alarm. Okay, this is an important one. So he has just fallen asleep and his first alarm goes off in B minutes. He wants to sleep for at least a minute and his alarm goes off in B minutes. Okay, every time Polycarp wakes up, he decides if he wants to go back to sleep for some more time or not. If he slept for less than a minute in total till now, then he sets his alarm to go off in C minutes after it is reset and spends D minutes to fall asleep again. Okay, I'll just read this line again by explaining it in a little bit more better way. The first thing is he wants to sleep for at least a minute, and the first time he sleeps, his alarm goes off in B minutes. Okay, so if basically B is greater than A, B is greater than or equal to A, it means that he would have slept for at least a minute after his first alarm, so he'll be good to go. Okay, but in other cases, every time he wakes up, he decides if he wants to go back to sleep or not. If he has slept for less than a minute in total till now, what he'll do is he'll set an alarm to go off after C minutes after this instant, okay, and then he'll sleep. But it says that he'll need D minutes to fall asleep again, so he'll not actually be asleep in the first D minutes, but he'll be asleep after D minutes that he has started falling asleep. Okay, otherwise he gets out of his bed and proceeds with the day. So if he has slept for at least a minute when he wakes up, so he'll just get out of the bed. Okay, if the alarm goes off while Polycarp is falling asleep, it means that during these D minutes, when he hasn't actually fallen asleep yet and he's in the procedure of it, in that case as well, he'll reset his alarm to go off in another C minutes and tries to fall asleep for D minutes again. Okay, you just want to find out when he will get out of bed or report it will never happen. Okay, so it says if something is unclear, we can check out the example. In the first example, we have A, B, C, D equals to 10, 3, 6, 4. Okay, so basically he wants to sleep A equals to 10 minutes. So he wants to be asleep for at least 10 minutes. Okay. But the value of B is 3. So it means that the first time he sleeps, he'll be up in 3 minutes, right? So he'll wake up after 3 minutes. Now he's only rested 3 minutes out of 10 minutes. So he wants to rest for 7 more minutes for now. So after he sets an alarm to go off in 6 minutes, because the value of C is 6, and spends 4 minutes falling asleep. So it means that he'll actually spend only 2 minutes sleeping, right? So every time he sets an alarm again and again, he'll be resting for 2 more minutes. Okay, totaling in 5 minutes of sleep. Okay, he'll rest for 5 minutes of sleep, but he'll actually spend 3 plus 6 minutes. He repeats the procedure 3 times more and ends up with 11 minutes of sleep. But finally, the time when he gets out of bed will be 4 times 6 plus 3, because every time after the first waking up of him, he'll, out of every 6 minutes, he'll be able to sleep for only 2 minutes, because the other 4 minutes he'll be trying to fall asleep. So first 3 minutes he'll sleep, and then in the next 6 minutes he'll sleep for 2 minutes. First 3 minutes he'll sleep for 3 minutes, and in the next 6 minutes he'll sleep for 2 minutes, then 6 again 2, 6 again 2, then 6 again 2. And then if we add these, 3 plus 4 times 2 equals 11. So after this much time, he would have slept for at least 10 minutes. He would have slept for 11 minutes, but the time that he would have spent in bed would have been 6 times 4 plus 3, which is 27. I hope the problem exactly is exactly clear after the first test case. So we'll just see the implementation of the solution. It is pretty straightforward. We just did what was asked to be done in the problem, and also we have to print minus 1 if it will never be able to complete his sleep. So yeah, the solution has loaded. So first we'll take the input of the number of test cases, and then we'll take the input of A, B, C, D, which are the input parameters. Now if A is less than or equal to B, it means that whenever the first alarm goes off, he would have already slept for 8 minutes, right? Because B is greater than or equal to A, then he'll be up then only. Okay, in that case he'll be up then only, the answer will be B, right? Else if D is greater than or equal to C, it basically means that whenever he, if we come to this else if, it means that after the first alarm, he wouldn't have really, completed his 8 minutes. He wants some more minutes to sleep. But every time he tries to sleep, he'll need T minutes to fall asleep, right? But the alarm will go off in C minutes only. So if D is greater than or equal to C, so it basically means he will never be able to rest for even 1 minute if D is greater than or equal to C. So he'll not actually be able to rest any more than B minutes that he rested in his first sleep. And in that case, our answer is going to be minus 1, because he'll just keep on repeating trying to sleep. But every time he is trying, the alarm will actually hit off before he fell asleep, right? I hope that makes sense. Else the case is that first it will sleep for B minutes, right? That is why I have initialized my answer with B. Then after that, he'll need A minus B more minutes of sleep, right? He has slept for B minutes already, so he needs A minus B more minutes to sleep. But we know that in every span of C minutes, he'll be able to sleep for only C minus D minutes, right? Because the alarm will go off in a time interval of C, but out of that time interval of C, he would be able to sleep for only C minus D minutes, right? So 1 equals to C minus D, that is the amount of time that he'll be able to rest in one cycle. And now we'll see how many more minutes that he, how many cycles will he require to actually complete the sleep. That will be C log basically more plus not exactly more plus C log more by 1. Why is this? Because we know that he needs at least more number of minutes to sleep, and he'll be getting a sleep of 1 minute in each cycle, so he'll need these many number of cycles, right? So we'll multiply it by C, so we'll have the number of minutes that he'll be requiring. So to calculate C of more by 1, there's a standard method. You can check why it works. You can dry run it on several cases. If you want the seal value of more by 1, what we can do is we can simply say more plus 1 minus 1 by 1's floor value. So that's what I have done here. A minus B is actually more only. Just add 1 minus 1 to it, 1 minus 1 to it, and divide it by 1. So we have the floor value, sorry, the seal value of more by 1. Multiply it by C. I'll have the number of minutes that it'll spend more. So I just add them to the answer. Initially it was B. I just add it to the answer and I print my answer. Okay. I hope the solution is clear to you guys. I hope the code is clear. If there is something I can help you more with, you might drop a comment. I'll try to reply. Okay. See you guys in the next one. Thank you.